Hello everyone. In the last video, we discussed about what is matter and what are the characteristics of particles of matter. And when we are discussing about the characteristics of particles of matter, we had decided that on the basis of those characteristics, we classify the matter. Right? So today we are going to classify the matter. The classification of matter is called as states of matter. States of matter. So there are five states of matter. First is solid state. Second is liquid state. Third is gaseous state. Fourth is BEC. BEC stands for Bose-Einstein condensate. And the last one is plasma. So these are the five states of matter. So states of matter means what? Matter are classified into basically these five categories, right? So solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. These three are already given in our NCERT book and that is in your course. But BEC and plasma, since they are recently discovered, so they are not in our course. Got it? So let's describe this first so that we can see it one by one. What is BEC? BEC is Bose-Einstein condensate. These two are the name of the scientist. Bose is the physicist. Einstein is also physicist. So they identified the states of matter which are different from these three. Right? That is BEC. BEC actually exists on extremely low temperature. Since it is not a very common states of matter, that's why it is not given in your course or not given. We are not commonly use it, right? And the last one is plasma. So plasma exists as extremely high temperature, right? So here we can write, you can note it also, exist at very low temperature. And this exists at extremely high temperature, like hot springs and all. So these two states of matter are not commonly used. Okay, so we in standard 8 in your NCERT book or in your for your examination, these two are not very much important. Okay. Now let's start with the first state of matter, that is solid state. So we just remove this and start with the first state of matter, that is solid state. So states of matter or the classification of matter basically depends on what? The arrangement of the particles. Right, the characteristic of the particle. So in solid state, if we see the arrangement of particles in the solid state, the particles are closely arranged, right? Closely packed, just like this. If we consider this circle, assume that these are identical circles. Right, if we consider these circles as particles, then in solid state, these particles are very closely arranged. Right, so when the particles are tightly packed, when the particles are closely arranged, then solid state is formed. Right, now when we are moving to the characteristic of solid state, we can see furthermore properties. Characteristics. So the
very first characteristic of solid state is shape and volume, or you can write shape and size. Right? So size, or we can say volume, both the terms we can use. So what about the shape and volume of solid states? Solid, we are not going to describe the examples of solid state because already you know, and already we discussed it in previous lecture, that there are so many things: a duster, chalk, this marker, table, board. These all are the examples of solid state, right? So what is the shape and volume of these solid particles, these solid matters, right? The shape and volume of these solid matters are fixed. It is fixed. What does it mean? If this marker occupies some area, or if this marker has this cylindrical shape, right? If we put it in other room, or if we put it in a jar, if we put it in water, its shape never changes, right? Neither its volume. Got it? So the shape and size, the shape and volume of the solid materials are fixed. Got it? Now moving towards the next characteristic, that is interparticle space. Now the term is not new for you because already you have learned what is interparticle space. In the previous lecture we had described it, that the space between the particles of the matter is called as interparticle space, right? Now the interparticle space, can you see the space present between the particles of the solid state? I'm just coloring it so that you can see it properly. What are the spaces present? I think it is visible now. So these colored parts we can say is the interparticle space, right? These are the interparticle space. So you can see it, since the particles are very closely arranged, that's why the interparticle space between the particles of solid state is very, very less. Right? Actually least among all the three states of matter. So interparticle space is very less, and due to the less interparticle space, the shape of the solid state is fixed. Got it? Now the third characteristic. The third characteristic of the solid state is force of attraction. Now again, we had discussed about these terms. What are the meaning of these terms, and why we consider these as the characteristic of particles of matter? So when we are talking about the force of attraction, since the particles are very closely bounded with each other, very closely binded with each other, so the force of attraction among the particles of a solid state is very high. Very high means the attractive force is very, very high. Right? Now, next one. After shape, interparticle space, force of attraction, what was else in our last class? It was the motion of the particle. And from that, we got the term kinetic energy. So when we are talking about the kinetic energy, its kinetic energy should be, it is very, very low. Why it is so? Since there is very less chances to movement of these particles. Since the particles are very closely arranged, so there is very less chance of movement of the particle. And since the chances are very less, that's why the kinetic energy is very low. Because if the movement is more, kinetic energy will be more. If the movement is less, the kinetic energy will be less. Since there is no scope for the movement of the particle. The particle just vibrate at their own position. There is no chances for the movement. They just vibrate because the particles of any matter are in continuous motion. That's why it just vibrate at its own position. So since the motion is very, very less, that's why the kinetic energy of the particles of solid state is very low. Right? Now, the next is density. Now this is a new term for you. Density is actually what? It is a physical quantity which has a formula mass by volume. Means what? The mass divided by volume gives the value of density. Clear? So it is clear that density is directly proportional to the mass and inversely proportional to the volume. Now what does it mean? What is directly proportional and inversely proportional? Directly proportional means when the masses increases, the density will also increase, and if the mass decreases, density will also decrease. And since volume by volume it is inversely proportional, so if the volume increases, density decreases, and if volume decreases, density increases. So you can write in the note, density is directly proportional to mass and inversely proportional to volume. Right? So density is directly proportional to mass. So what about the mass of a solid state? What about the mass of the solid materials? So the mass of any solid material is high. Okay, it is heavier than the other states of matter. That's why the mass is always more than the other states of matter. That's why its density is also more. If we consider the second factor, that is the volume, then also density will be more is proved. How it is? Volume of any solid material is very, very low. This is because if we contract the particles together, then obviously the space will be less and less. And since the space will be less, volume will be less, and volume will be less, then the density will also be less. Density will be increases. Got it? So by both the factor, we can say that density of solid state has high density. So the density of solid state are high. Clear? Now, after these five, these are the main characteristics of solid state. After these five, we are having another property which is called as rigidity. This property is only for the solids. Only solids have this property that they are rigid in nature. So solids are rigid in nature. Rigid means what? We cannot change the shape and size of any of the solid material. As for example, if you are talking about this marker, its shape, we cannot change the shape of this marker, right? So it is obvious that its shape is rigid, so its nature is rigid. So all the solid material have the rigid nature, except since we are talking about the chemistry, we are always have an exception. Here the exception is rubber, or we can say elastic material. Elastic material. I am having a rubber over here. This is an elastic material. Right? We can change its shape. It is not rigid in nature. We can stretch it. We can change its shape. Right? But when we are applying force, then only it changes its shape. When we are removing it, our force, then it regains its original shape. Got it? So, it is a solid substance. If anyone asks you, why rubber is considered as a solid substance? Because it is not rigid. So, why it is considered as a solid substance? Your answer will be, since to change its shape and size, we need external energy. And when we remove that external energy, it comes back to its original position or its original shape. right? That's why it is considered as a solid substance. So all solids are rigid except the elastic material, right? I think the explanation is clear to you now why the rubber or the elastic material is considered as the solid substance. Now the next property which we are having after the rigidity is compressibility. So solids are non-compressible. Any solids are non-compressible. We cannot compress it. Right? We cannot compress this duster. So compressibility is also one of the factor, one of the characteristic of solid state, that is they are non-compressible. They cannot be compressed, right? But there are again some exceptions. Here the exception is sponge. See this sponge, we can compress the sponge easily. Okay? You can see it, we can compress it. Right? This is because of the air spaces present between the pores of a spore. This can easily be explained. अगर इसको आपने पानी में डाला, ठीक है, और आप इसको निकालते हो और इसको squeeze करते हो, water comes out. Right? It means what? This sponge contains some air spaces. Right? So due to that air spaces, it can be compressed, right? That is due to the air, that is due to the gaseous state, not due to its solid nature, right? So solids are non-compressible, or we can say incompressible, that is more authentic word, incompressible except the sponges, right? So I think these are the characteristic we can summarize it as characteristic of solid states. First is shape and volume. So the shape and volume of solid states are fixed. Second is interparticle space. So the interparticle space between the particles of solid state is very, very less. Third is force of attraction. Force of attraction is very high, right? Then kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is very low, right, due to the less chances of movement of the particles. Then we are having density. Density is very high because the mass of solid substance is very high and the volume is very less. Other is rigidity. So solid materials are rigid in nature except the elastic material. And then the compressibility. So the compressibility of when we are talking about the compressibility of solid state, they are incompressible, right? So this is all about the solid state. Now if we want to talk about the liquid state, we can continue with the same things. Our parameters are set. Now we just have to change it, we just have to compare it with the solid, how it looks like, how it behaves, how their particles move, right? So when we are just changing our topic to the next states of matter, that is liquid state. So the second state, the second state of matter which we are having is liquid state. Got it? So here just write solid so that you don't get confused between these two diagrams when we are making the liquid state. I think by the diagram only your picturization of liquid state is clear, and you can now write the characteristic of all the characteristic of the liquid state, right? What about the shape and volume of liquid state? It's just a general question. You have water, right? You have taken 1 liter of water in mug, okay? Then you just put that 1 liter of water in bottle. So what happens there? The shape of the water changes, right? Similarly for lemon juice, similarly for milk, right? So we can say that shape and volume
shape of liquid state, not fixed, but volume is fixed.
Since the particles are slightly far apart, it's not very far from each other, that's why their volume are fixed. If we have taken 1 liter of water, that will not change if we pour it in other container, right? The volume remains same, only the shape changes. Got it? That's why we can say the shape of liquid is not fixed, but the volume is fixed. Second is what? Interparticle space. Now you can see it clearly. What about the interparticle state? Interparticle space. It is more than the liquid, more than the solid state. Right? You just write. Do a comparative study. It's my suggestion. Just always go for the comparative study. Okay. So interparticle space we can say more than solids. Right? Now when we talk about the force of attraction. What about the force of attraction? The particles are somewhat far apart. So the force of attraction will be less than that of the solid. Solid mein kya tha? Particles sare close the. Liquid mein kya hai? Thodi thodi distance pe. Jab thoda distance create ho gaya, to obvious baat hai ki attractive force jo hoga automatic kam ho jayega. Okay, so we can write less than solids. Less than solids. Now what about the kinetic energy? Since there are some space, these are the spaces, right? So these are the spaces. So there are chances of movement of the particle. Space hoga to kya hoga? Movement, move karenge particles. Since there are spaces between the particles, that's why there is chances of movement of the particles. Right, so kinetic energy is more than solids. Clear? If we are talking about the density, what will be the density? Density is what? Mass by volume. Already we know the mass of a solid substances and the liquid substances differ from each other. If we have the same measurement of the solid substance and liquid substance, their masses differ. Always the mass of a solid substance is higher than that of, or we can say greater than that of the liquid state. Since mass of liquid substance is less than the solid and volume is more than the solids, that's why its density is lower than the solids. They are low density. Clear? When we are talking about rigidity, they are not rigid in nature. Okay, not rigid. Since their shape changes, that's why, since their shape is not fixed, that's why they are not having rigid nature. Right? Compressibility, they are also non-compressible as the solids. Got it? So when we are comparing the solid and the liquid state, you can memorize it very clearly. In liquid state, the shape is not fixed, but the volume is fixed. In liquid state, interparticle space is more than the solids. In liquid state, force of attraction among the particle is less than the solids. Kinetic energy is more than the solid because there is more chances of movement. That's why their kinetic energy is more. Density is less. Rigidity, they are not rigid in nature, and compressibility, they are non-compressible in nature. So today we just covered the two broad states of matter, that is the solid state and the liquid state. In the next lecture, I'll continue with the gaseous state and the comparative study of solid, liquid and gaseous state. So I think that's all for this lecture. You just go through the points, you just compare the points so that you will already convinced about the characteristic of the particles of a gaseous state. Thank you.